In today's video, I'm going to upgrade a 3018 CNC, increasing the size of the table, installing a 500W spindle motor, and increasing the Z-axis clearance height. To increase the table size, I'm going to use a Sainsmart Genmitsu 3040 Y-axis extension kit. These are available for the 3018 Pro, Prova, and MX3. Okay, so let's get started. First, I'm going to remove the gantry from the 3018, unplug the wiring, and then dismantle the base frame. That's the base frame disassembled, so now I'm going to rebuild it with the new components from the Y-axis kit. I'm checking that the base frame is square by making sure that the diagonal measurements are equal. Next, we need a larger table bed. It's easy enough to make one, but Sainsmart also have two options, the Genmitsu 3040 MDF Spoilboard or the Genmitsu 3040 Aluminium Spoilboard Extension Kit. I'm going to try both, starting with the MDF table. To prevent the table hitting the base frame, spacers are used to increase the clearance between them. Now the cabling is reinstalled, with the Y-axis limit switch cable replaced with the longer one supplied in the kit. That's the machine assembled, and I can run a homing cycle. The only software configuration change is to update the Gerbil $131 Y-axis maximum travel limit setting. Typing $$ in the console shows the current settings. I've measured the new value as 315 mm. To change the setting, I enter $131 equals 315 into the console. If you're not using a 3018 Prova, this will be a different value. Next, I'm going to install a spoilboard and face it with a 22 mm bit. To reduce the dust, I'm fitting a dust boot that I made in a previous video. It could do with a skirt, but it still catches a lot of fine dust. I cut out some 6 mm or 1/4 inch plywood which worked fine without any problems. The spindle can be replaced with a laser module, combined with the larger table. This is quite a useful combination. Next, I tried out the aluminium spoilboard kit. This includes a new aluminium table, which is joined to the old table with an MDF backing board. The new table is 9mm thicker than the original, and this amount is lost in the clearance height. There is, however, an easy way of gaining that back and more, which I'll show later in the video. The acrylic side plates can be reinstalled. The cutting area is the same as with the MDF table. I reinstalled the spoilboard and cut some more of the 6mm or 1/4 inch plywood. There's not any noticeable difference in rigidity with either of the tables installed. It works the same as before the size increase. Next, I installed a 52mm diameter aluminium spindle holder, which is a complete new Z-axis assembly. The spring in the anti-backlash mechanism is compressed while the lead screw is installed, which should result in a slight gap under the screw head. The old spindle motor cable can be removed before reinstalling the stepper motor and limit switch cables. I'm going to install a 500W 52mm spindle motor that I used in a previous video. The power supply is installed in an earth steel case, and because the output from the power supply is mains referenced, I've also earthed the spindle motor body. The axes are all moving okay. I haven't connected the spindle motor to the controller. On, off and speed are both manual. The maximum speed is about 12,000 RPM. Once again, I tried cutting 6mm plywood. Next, I tried cutting some 1.5mm thick aluminium sheet. I used a candle to probe the surface and create a height map. The machine isn't very stiff, so I set the depth of cut to 0.1mm. I increased the depth of cut to 0.5mm, but he didn't sound very happy. So I set the depth of cut back to 0.1mm and then started increasing the feed rate. To gain some extra height, I tried attaching the original side rails to the top of the new rails. I used 6 of the aluminium plates that I cut earlier. The clearance height is increased by 40mm, but it can be set lower. I tested it on a length of 2x4. Using a 4-flute 6mm end mill, I cut some pockets using different cut depths and feed rates. You can hear the difference when the depth of cut is increased. Okay, so that worked pretty well. Increased table size makes for a more useful machine. I have a slight preference for the aluminium table over the MDF table, but they both worked fine. The aluminium spindle holder is nicely made. It has a height adjustment knob that I forgot to mention earlier. And because it's solid aluminium, it acts as a heat sink, helping to keep the spindle motor cool. None of these changes make the 3018 more rigid, and that ultimately limits how aggressively you can operate it. So I hope that was useful. Thanks for watching. And I'll see you again next time.